fresh out the slammer. No diddy.
We interrupt what Dylan's about to say. This video is sponsored by Blue Heat Takis. Blue Heat Takis. It's sponsored by Blue Heat Takis. It's not sponsored by Blue Heat Takis. Oh, shit. I spilled my Taylor Swift teacup. Wow, that was a quick escalation of this video. All right, you know what? It was only a little bit. It'll be fine. It builds character.
So did you guys hear about this? Yeah, the reason I said that is mainly because boys go into prison, jail,
jail,
like, you know.
Guess
like,
who's rah. Going to jail tonight? Oh shit! It went back to him again.
Fuck's sake. Okay, we'll leave that. Whatever. Yeah. Go check out the. Find it. You'll watch through them. Get the watch time up. Thank you guys.
That little bit lagged out there, and all I heard is, go check out the you get the watch time up. So there.
I said just go find it.
Oh, yeah.
One of the videos.
Damn, you can't. All right, go find it. Anyway, we move. Oh, shit. Hold on. Today is fresh out
quit
the slammer.
Quit with the R's. Just say the
I'm
words.
I'm panicking because there's something I wasn't trying to verbally say out loud in the fucking video. But here you are drawing attention to it. There's a fucking problem. Sorry, I did it. I'm mimicking you. That was my mimic voice, to be fair, this time. What is this?
Okay, look, anyway, guys, welcome back to Torture Poets Department Reaction. I'm going to take over the intro because Zach can't think of more than two words to say. Like, it's a fucking Joe Biden speech. Anyway, this song is track 7, Fresh Out the Slammer. All the other reactions we have done are on a playlist on our channel, already out. And that's all needs to be said.
We're having a slight issue right now. So, yeah, hold on. Da 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 da. I'm entertaining. Da 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 da. Fuck me. So we're having a pretty big error right now. Your screen share will not pop up. Like, it will not load up for whatever reason. It just will not come up. It's just not coming up. Oh, here we go. We're good. Sorry, guys. Bad error. That's why I was stuttering like that. It's because I was trying to figure out how to fix this problem. But we fixed it. All right. It wouldn't be an Integrity Music Group video without something going horribly fucking wrong. But we move. Let's go listen to a song now. You've clicked the timestamp anyway. Let's get going. This is still shorter than, like, half of our intros. So.
Oh wait, shit, we never tested the Spotify audio, it's gonna be low.
Fuck! It's good, leave it, it's good. Turn it up just a little bit.
Good there?
Just a little bit higher. Alright, this is fucking... Let's restart the fucking song. Timestamp here, everybody. Thank you for clicking the timestamp.
Is it good? Is the audio good?
Yeah, it's fine. Timestamp here. Fuck.
No genius, I don't want so long London.
It's a great song though. Okay. We reacted to it on our channel. Pretty baby, I'm running back home to you. Fresh out the slammer, I know who my first call will be to. Fresh who? The question
okay,
is, who's the call
to?
There
may have to be a few extra pauses in this song.
Who's the
call to? Because the time signature, the tempo means that each segment seems like it's going to be like 30-something seconds, which is means I'm going to have to pause every 30-something seconds.
That's fine. Who's she going to call? But, that's the question.
Who's she going to call? Ghostbusters.
That's really wild that we... Okay, anyway. That and or maybe, you know, quite possibly... Maybe famous football player Travis Kelce, is it him?
Oh crap. Guys, you brought out the Swiftie and Zach. He's going crazy about the ships and stuff. He's about to... How about this, guys? Once we get more educated on Taylor Swift, we'll do a Taylor Swift ship ranking. And just rank all her relationships. Like.
I guess...
Well, John Mayer, well, he was a cunt.
F. Tell you what, I can't lie. After listening to Taylor Swift's music, I really saw John Mayer in a new light. Anyway, we continue on with the song.
Wow. No, honestly, I think just put every relationship that ended, put it in an F tier, because it clearly ended for a
evidently
reason.
Evidently, it was a bad one, yeah. F for ending.
F for ending.
Damn.
Dude, wasn't wow. The rhyming again? The fuck?
I'm telling you. Splinter back in winter, silent dinner's bitter. He was with her in her dreams. Damn! Word! That's what I just heard. That's all I heard.
Damn.
I heard this is like the old Southern twang came back for a minute. We just got straight Ryan Upchurch or Trent Morgan Wallen. I said Taylor Swift needs to make like a hardcore rap album. I mean it. Just a hardcore fucking, yeah. We need it, we need it, we need it. Anyway.
She might have a rap song here that we don't
anyway,
know about.
Anyway, also, he was with her in her dreams, okay? That's wild. Burst cheating in and out of sleep. Not really, I don't know that he's cheating. It's just he was with her in her dreams, a little sketch. Anyway, we can continue. I know it's going to be two. It's okay, going to be the Ghostbusters. I'm going to bet on that, okay? I'm going to put $500 on the Ghostbusters. That's my bet. Well. $500 on the Ghostbusters. That's what I'm doing.
Fuck you, I'm putting $600.
Fuck you, I'm putting $700. I would like to keep doing this a little bit, but unfortunately the delay is so atrocious that it would take an extra hour. So the 4-hour breaks in between each one of our bets isn't worth it.
Yeah, no, we want to be done this by Tuesday.
Yes, hopefully.
Anyway, Tuesday, I'm really liking the melody there. That chorus is, like, that chorus is already stuck in my head. Maybe because the melody reminds me of a song that I like the melodies of, but I hated the message of, so never went back to. The vocal delivery and the melody there sounds similar to Single Soon by Selena Gomez, which is ironic because a lot of people said that that was a Taylor Swift copy.
Well, Taylor, explain
and
yourself.
And now here Taylor is herself. And
you could say this was a
Taylor-made
copy.
As well.
Copy. Fuck. I fucked it up.
Yeah.
I fucked up.
But no, with Single Soon, like, I liked that melody. Or the melody that sounds... It's not the same melody, but a similar-ish. I did like it in Single Soon. The only issue was I had with that song and why I never went back to it was the message. Well, Taylor doesn't seem to have that problem here, so I'm definitely going back to this one already. That chorus is really... really stuck in.
I like it a lot. I'm ready to continue, honestly.
And also when she said, like, you know, it's gonna be alright, I've did my time. So, she's basically saying, you know, she felt like she was in jail when she was in the relationship. And now that she's out of the relationship, she feels like she's fresh out of prison. That's the whole meaning I'm getting here. Handcuffed to the spell I was under for just 1 hour of sunshine. So... which is obviously a reference to, like, jail, for instance. They get locked inside all day, and they might get, like, an hour outside. Or whatever.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Nice stuff. Yeah. Good songwriting.
Can I interrupt briefly? This is a quick little question I have to the audience. This is particularly for my, female audience. Would you say that regulated outdoors time is a red flag in a man? Because to me, I think it is. Because I think that that's kind of fucking sketch.
Regulated.
Exactly. That's what she's talking about out here.
Regulated.
That's what she said he did. Fucking 1 hour outside. What is it? Fucking scheduled? Honey, your outdoors time. The alarm's going off. You may exit the home. Like, what?
No.
It's fucking wild.
I actually think it's a little dirty reference, to be honest with you. I think she's saying...
What?
Like, I don't think she's talking about sunshine. I think she's talking about, like, the hour of sunshine you get in prison, right? But I also think it maybe might be a little, like, dirty joke about the fact that maybe, like, the sex was good. Maybe it's, like, an hour of sunshine.
No, I feel like everything you do goes sexual. Like, we even got a comment. We even got a comment about one of your...
No, I legit think, though...
Everything you do goes sexual.
That might actually be a thing. I'm not just...
I was dead ass at work today thinking about our videos, and I was like, wait a minute. I thought of like four things. I was like, why does Dylan always think the table? Why does he always think the lyrics are leaning at a dirty hint? It's always you with that shit. I didn't hear it that way at all. I heard it as like.
Songwriters like Taylor Swift do it all the time. Because she said. Subliminals and stuff. Olivia Rodrigo,
Hold on. Handcuff for the spell I was under. For just 1 hour of sunshine. Yeah, no, that could be it. It could, and honestly, no, going back of that line, this one might be the exception. That one actually does kind of make sense that way. Rereading, I missed part of that line. It does make sense. Yeah, that kind of makes sense. That, either that, or, like, they're just, like, the hour could be referencing either, one, something sexual, or two, like, maybe, like, something, like, maybe, like, a good part that, I'm saying like and Jesus Christ, take time to think. What I'm saying is,
like, just little good
it
moments.
It could also be referencing, like, the highs and the things that make her want to stay in the relationship, but not. Guys, I want to apologize for my sporadic talking. I wasn't even paying attention to the fact that I was doing it, so I'm slowing it down now. My apologies. Not psych, fuck y'all. I'm just kidding. Yeah. Go ahead. I love you, I'm sorry. Guys. Bars?
Wait, hold on. What the a beat switch?
That was a weird switch. That was weird.
Hold on.
She's fucking rapping.
She really is doing the
I'm
rap.
I'm telling
fucking...
you. She pulled up. She said, wait. She said, I swear to God, if like hardcore drums come in, she goes, oh, wait, ain't that something? Drums came in. You ain't see that coming. I'm going to lose my shit. I'm going to lose my shit. Kendrick Lamar feature? It's a part. Sorry, it's a part of the beat. They don't know what we're talking about, so. Well, maybe you do. I trust you guys.
Okay, I'm going to need to speed that back because you...
Yeah. It was... I didn't hear... It took me a second to realize I was playing. To the house, we still wait up in that porch light, please. To the one who says I'm the girl of his American dreams. Bah. And no matter what I've done, it wouldn't matter anyway. Ain't no way I'm gonna screw up now that I know what's at stake here. Sponsored by Steak. At the park where we used to sit on children's swings. That's... Wearing imaginary rings.
I mean, yeah, the songline is continuing to
be
really good here. And I'm really liking that melody. And the slowdown actually really works for the song. Like, it adds actually a bunch to it.
Imaginary rings is a cool way to say that. Like, almost like you're not married or engaged, but you're kind of in lock with each other.
We'll roll the outro and then we'll talk the last thoughts. But it's gonna be alright. I did my time. Really like the really quiet fade out there.
Yeah. And the sounds they're choosing. After the song, after
so
this video,
diversification of it. Yeah, you can tell the album is definitely getting more diverse as we get more in. Like that was definitely one of the slower ones on here. I say one of the slower ones. It was the slowest one on here.
Yeah, I liked it.
But no, I really love the slowdown part at the end there. I think that works really well. It actually adds to a lot of the emotion as well, because it's kind of like maybe the first feeling was like, okay, she's fresh out the slammer now, whatever. She's kind of in this like middle tone. Like she's not happy, but she's not like sad. And at the end of it, she's like coming to the realization that, oh, like it's over. Like it's over.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think, I mean, it's actually ironic. You could say the dog days are over. That's just a great reference to the next song. Don't know if Zach caught it or not.
I didn't, because I'm not staring at the track list right now like you are. So,
no, Dog Days Are Over is Florence and the Machine's biggest song.
Oh. No, I didn't get that. No.
Oh, well, anyway, yeah. There's that.
My apologies. Sorry, guys.
Overall, yeah. Sorry, guys. I don't know. I'm not going to repeat myself too much. Songwriting's perfect. The vocals were terrific. The melody's already caught my head, so absolutely going back to it. And yeah, the vocal style was very different.
Oh, my God.
Not different. Similar to the Selena Gomez one, which is why, like, I can see now, although I think it is inverse. Like, maybe there's some Taylor stuff I haven't heard that the Selena one sounds like. And maybe that's why. Or maybe I just completely missed something on, like, Midnights or whatever that she cribbed from or something. So, I don't know. Either way, love it. So, 7 for 7.
Yeah. Same. I think consistency-wise, 7 for 7. I need to go back to them more listen to it. I was able to go back to a few. Every time I hear the songs, it gets better. This song had a slower vibe. I'm liking the fact that the last few songs have swapped it up a little. And that's the main thing that I was like looking forward to in the rest of the album, was to see what would change. I really don't feel like, I feel like I'm beating a dead horse by saying this, but once again, the analogies in the song are great. And the way it's written is a great concept. Everything's written well. I don't know exactly how I felt about the little beat switch. It felt a little, like, sporadic. Like, when it first came in, I felt like there were some sporadic parts. Almost felt a little glitchy, which could have been intentional. Also, I don't know if this was intentional at all, but the fact that the beat switch at the end, like, how it changed up at the end, could have been in reference to the kind of concept of the song, which is that she was locked into something and then completely got out of something and changed it entirely. Like, she was free from something. So that could have been the change there. It could have been intentional. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't want to really look for something that I don't see immediately. Another great song, really. Other than that, that's all I have to say. Is that all you have to say? I know there's like a little bit.
That's all I have to say.
If you guys want to leave a comment, feel free. We read them all. We appreciate them. If you want to tell us anything about this song or any of the songs or anything you liked or didn't like, let us know. We have our own music. Plan on releasing some of new ones soon. We kind of been at it for a while. Likes help, subscribes help. You already know. I'm not gonna shove it at you. Everyone, you know the drill. But Dylan, I think it's where you say goodbye. All the other reactions are out too. Speak Now, 1989, and this one, they're all out. Sorry. I didn't, all of them. They have a shit ton of Taylor Swift. Probably 60, 70 plus. So it's probably 60 videos. Go look. Just go on the channel. You'll find it all there. All right. Dylan, now this is where you say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye, fellas.